Well, welcome back to the studio. Today I'm working on this little burrow. And the perspective looks a little skewed because I have to put the camera off to the side in order to work and to show you what I'm doing, but that will just have to be, that's just the way it is. So I'm starting out with a mixture of, this is mud plus a little bit of burnt umber and white. And my mud is the alizarin crimson plus ultramarine blue. And the burnt umber just sort of dulls the color a little bit. Now this mixture I'm using is my mud plus cadmium red light plus a little bit of cadmium orange plus white. So I use several different mixes here. I start blocking in the shadow parts of his head. I have white around his eye, but the sunlight catches this little bone right here, right at the top of his cheek. Come around here. Put some of my darks into his neck. This is all shadow. In fact, his ear will cast a shadow. Well, let's see. Light's coming from this direction. Yeah, the shadow will cast across his neck here. A little more light up here. And he's got kind of a heavy, fluffy coat. Burrows just have sort of a thick coat, so it's not real smooth. Come here. Now the light is hitting his crest of his neck right there, so you'll see that behind his ear. This side of his face is light. They usually have a little, the hair kind of makes a neat little cowlick right there in the center of their forehead. Get his cheekbone there with light. Come down. This is the bridge of his nose. Now his nose, coming down around his nostrils and all, is white. So this is a mixture of my mud plus a little ultramarine blue plus a little bit of those browns that comes down on the side of his face here. I'm just bracing my hand, you don't see it, but I'm just bracing against the bottom of the canvas here to steady my hand as I start working on his nose and around his nostrils. I love these little burrows. They're just darling. They're always fun to do with big baskets of flowers. You see lots and lots of them in Greece. They're used for their transportation because, like in some of those villages like Santorini and Mykonos, the pathways are so steep and narrow that you really can't get trucks and stuff. So they use burros as their delivery trucks. This is white plus just a tiny bit of mud in it. Just kind of make the outside of that nostril. I'm going to bring this shadow back here on my stone wall. I'm going to go ahead and take this here so you'll really see his nostril against that darker, the light of his nostril. Here I'm using just a mixture of mud plus liquin. I'm going to put his little nostril in there. just see a little bit of the edge of this one from this angle, but you just get a little bit of that darkness in there. And now this nostril, see a little bit more of it. I'm also using my Mud Plus Liquid to put his eyes in. I'll come back in and work a little bit more on his eyes. But right now, that's, we've got those in. Now, around his eyes are lighter. So I use that lighter mix. I need to get my Mall Stick. Grab that. I have it hanging on the side of my easel. And this is one, I know you've, if you've watched my videos before, you've seen me show this, but this is a hook that's made for taking clothes off of a tall hanging rack in a store. We got that at the Container Store years and years ago. It hooks over the top of my easel, and I can rest my hand on it, and I can do these small details. That's in light, but this under his eye now is going to be a little bit in shadow because the side of his head is casting a shadow. So this I'm using a mixture of mud plus white, and that's just a little bit, it's more in shadow. In fact, I'm going to add a little blue into that. This is my ultramarine blue plus white. That just drops that back. The blue in that makes it drop back. A little white on the bridge of his nose, but the sunlight's really catching it. And there's going to be a little bit right here. There's a little plane here that catches the light. This comes down. See, it's a little lighter. Well, meant to make that lighter, but I may have to, actually that probably should be darker there. And then I'm going to make that cactus behind his head just a little bit lighter. I've saved that color, so that'll accentuate his head. That'll kind of silhouette his head. So I'm going to make this a little bit lighter. It really helps to save your colors. I just place them on the left side of my palette, and then that way if I need a color, I can just go back and I've got it right there. I don't have to worry about doing any mixing or anything. See, now we see the side of his head. His eye comes down a little bit more. There's going to be a little catch light here in his eye where the sun catches his eye. Got that a little bit big, but I need to get it a little wider. And I'll come back. Get a little bit smaller. There we go. And then there's a little bit of a reflected light onto his iris. That'll come down. Not much. In fact, I need to make his pupil just a little bit bigger, make the dark of his eye. It's just very faint, but that helps to give his eye. Some soul. Make him look alive. Sometimes you have to go back and do this a few times. Now this lighter portion under his eye comes up just a little. There we go. Now I need to bring this lighter portion, this over. And then my darker, this is a little bit hard in here. I'll just soften this. In fact, here's what I'm gonna do. This I don't like. I'm not getting the planes of my head in there properly, so there we go. This will have a little more light up here. So the sunlight's hitting his head almost straight on. Now they have a little down the middle of their ridge of their nose, there's a little indentation where the two bones come together, their nasal bones come together on the front of their skull. That's a little bit dark. Just having a hard time getting what I want here. But you can always go back in and lighten it up. There we go. Now I'm going to take a little bit of my mud plus white and continue this indentation down into the white part of his face. This comes up here. There we go. There we go. Now we're starting to get it. Now I need a little bit of a dark here, where his face comes down to that cheekbone. And then there's going to be a little light on his brow here, just above his eye, where that white comes around. And then I need a little light hitting his cheekbone right here. There we go. Now I'm going to do the bottom of his muzzle. Make it a little bit lighter right here so he stands out from that stone wall behind him. So we see the bottom of his muzzle. And this side of his muzzle down here is darker. It's going to extend down. I'm going to let that stone wall be just a little bit lighter behind him so that you can see his face there. That dark comes down. It's a matter of pushing and pulling. And by saving my colors, I can come back in and work. And I don't have to worry about mixing or anything. I can just come back in and work on him. It's a little bit darker there. Smooth out the edge of his nostril a little bit. And this is going to be a little lighter around the edge of this nostril. And then I'm going to hit a little highlight right here on the edge of this nostril here, on the outer edge, and then where his nose, just this little soft, oh, their muzzles are so soft. Love rubbing their noses. I want to soften that just a little bit. Got that a little bit light, so I can just come back and that just a touch. I've got this, I need to darken this just a little bit in this area over here. Bring this dark down. Just soften that edge a little bit and just bring that down a little, soften it. Yeah, there we go. Okay. That pretty well gets his head done. I'm going to add a little dark right here, and then just a touch of my blue, ultramarine blue, plus a tiny bit of mud plus white, just to kind of give a shape of his head there, right underneath his ear. There we go. Now his neck kind of bulges down over that strap going around his chest, breastplate, they would call that. And he's a little bit lighter back here. Again, his hair is kind of rough, so I don't make him just real, he's not real sleek and smooth. They have a real thick, heavy coat. Now his shoulder here is going to be lighter where the sun hits it, that plane of his shoulder right here. Well, if I would get my lighter color on my brush, but that's a little bit lighter. Point of his shoulder, presses out against that chest breastplate, and I'm going to soften this a little bit where it comes into his shoulder. And he's going to have a little more light right in here. Again, his hair is pretty rough, so he's not a sleek, smooth like a horse would be. Now let's do his ears. Let me work on this shadow a second, just roughen the edges of that. Again, that hair is not real smooth. Make sure my totally covered in here. I want a little bit light right here also on the top of his shoulder, where his neck comes into his shoulder. Okay, now his ears, the tips of his ears, I'm using ivory black. They kind of go along the edges. And also he's got his little mane is dark, and I'm going to use ivory black for that. It just comes, he's got a little bit of a forelock that just works into his neck. And I let some of his neck color come up into the hair so it's not solid black. Again, they don't have a long mane like a horse, just a little fuzz, kind of, not much. I just let some of that hair from his neck come up into his mane. I do want that light on his neck to show, because that helps define his ear. Light's hitting him right up here. then he's going to be a little lighter right in here so that you see the shadow from the from his ear coming up across. I think I'm going to let that shadow kind of go up here a little bit. There we go. Okay, that's got that. And donkey and burros have a little, you won't see much of it here, but they have a cross on their shoulders. They have a stripe that comes down. And they say that's from Christ, that when he rode the burro into Jerusalem on Palm Sunday, that after that, burros always had that cross. They carried the cross of Christ. Let's work on these ears. Their ears are so expressive. I need to make this a little bit smaller, so I'm going to make some of my Adobe color. And again, I've got that. I had saved some of my mixtures, so I can just come back in and make that a little bit narrower there. His head, his skull extends up a little bit here. The light might be a little bit too light. Let me. And the depth of the ear gets dark. And these long, this furry hair inside their ear is lighter. It's just so fun to rub their ears. Ears and nostrils. Ears and muzzles and the nostrils. They're just really neat. They have real long, long hair in their ears. I'm going to make this edge of his ear a little bit darker so it stands out against that wall, because this is, there we go. Now I think again I'm going to have to take some of my Adobe color and come back in and work around this. Clean my brush a lot. I dip it in my thinner and then wipe it with tissue. And I use the tissue two or three times and I throw it away so I don't end up with paint all over me and everywhere else. I have an artist friend who I paint with occasionally and she hangs onto her tissue. She gets the teeniest little piece of tissue and she uses it as about 100 times and ends up with paint on her hands, on her face, and but that's her method of painting and it works for her. But I'm going to put a little bit more of the light here. Make that ear. Get those fluffy ears. Have a little bridle, and I'm just trying to think. I think we'll have a leather strap coming around his head, and then a colored nose or a colored brow band. So he's, and it's not really a bridle, it won't have a bit, but it will have side straps, and then it'll have a nose band coming. I think I'm going to make the nose band higher. Huh, what color would that be? Let's make it turquoise like the bench. That nose band just comes over top of his nose, and the sunlight will hit it same as on his head. Goes over. Now that's also going to make a shadow across the bridge of his nose. Come down. And then the headband, that's why I need to make a little indentation here from his ears. They get darker right in there. And he's going to be a little darker going up to his mane right there. There we go. And this is a little lighter. Now the headband, I'm going to make it the turquoise, and we'll add a little red into it, but it's going to come down and have a little tassel on it. Just kind of a fun. I have a couple little like red beads on there. And it comes down. We'll make that little tassel. I'm using some of my door color. This is cadmium red light. Make a little cross piece of the tassel. And then this is just fun to do. Little extra goodies. Then that also has his cast a shadow on his face, across his head. And I need to add the highlights on that turquoise. By saving my bench color and all, I just have the color right there. Now I'm going to mix, this is cadmium red light plus white. This just gives me a little brighter highlight there. Got a little shadow darker right here. That sun is, that's right on his forehead, so it's a got a shadow right here. See, the sun is, yeah, this will be a little bit lighter right here. His head's, he has an indentation right here in his temple. And then this is a little bit lighter right here. Get my light color. And there we go. That's the donkey's head and neck and his little halter. I appreciate you following my YouTube videos. Please subscribe to my channel. Also, I have a blog where I show the complete step-by-step process of this painting as well as others I do. The address is in the description below. It's also on the final frame of the video. You have a wonderful, wonderful day, and thank you again.